a little bit of everything. Some different relics, maps, paintings. Yeah, we have some vintage stuff, some antique stuff, if you're interested. Paintings. Yes. Yes, we have. Kind of style, pictures of landscapes. Yes. Yeah, we have a few landscape pictures that I could show you if you're interested. Yeah, of course. Any specific size? Okay. Not huge. I brought over 5 paintings and I have 3 different sizes, so you can kind of decide which one you like best, but all of them are reasonably sized, so you won't be walking out of here with anything ginormous. Yeah, of course. So the first one that I have here is our smallest in terms of our landscape pictures, so I'll show you. Grassland area. Yeah, kind of like an ancient African or Egyptian, if you will, kind of atmosphere. Yeah, of course. can see the bridge connecting the two lands and the trees and the bushes. And you can see the water. I love the water. You can see how it really starts out as like a teal color. And really as it gets closer fades into a darker blue. I absolutely love the fade for this painting. And you can see the grass. It's pretty bright, yeah. And right here you can see that there is a teepee. I believe this painting was based off of the a trip that the painter took to Mackinac Island. And I believe when she was there, she stayed in an Airbnb that was a teepee right on the water and looked just like this. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, if you plan another trip there, you'll have to look it up. It does sound very cool. So, as you can see, this one's a little bit bigger than the other one, but still very reasonable. You can still hold it in your hands and just walk out. One more in this size, and then two that are just a little bit bigger, but again, reasonable. Yeah, I'll be right back. Okay, so this next one is also a landmark painting, and it's a little bit more colorful than the last one. Is that? Yeah, you like color. Me too. So it's this painting of you can see the beautiful Key West sunset. How it makes everything look a little rainbowy. Yeah. I like it. You can see a pretty clean break between the clouds and the sky underneath it, which I really like, because I really just remember, you know, what it would look like that. With almost completely green, and it fades almost to a deep purple color. Yeah, I love it. And then you can see for this one, the painter has added some wave caps. Yeah. Which I think is fitting. It is the same painter for all the paintings, yes. So anyway, you can see in the foreground, there's just sand from the beach, but she's also added a little tiny crab and a little tiny sea star. Yeah. Wave cap. First one. Down from the top also have a light dusting of snow. Then there's this icy, snowy foreground. So it would almost be like if you were looking at this mountain range from over a frozen lake with some snow. It's such clean hopefully a little bit better for us. So the last thing that I really like about this painting is the snow. So if you look very closely, you can see that there's a couple different colors of snowflakes that are coming down, and a bunch of different sizes of snowflake. So again, I don't know if her intention here was to make them just different sizes and very random, or if her intention was just to have some look like they were closer. So that is our snowscape. as I mentioned, this one is the complete opposite. There's a very big contrast between the two, and you'll see what I mean. So, this one is a desert landscape. So, obviously, the temperature difference, just in knowing the places and how they would feel, but also the temperature differences in the colors. So, where you had one was icy blues and whites and purples, this one is pinks and oranges and browns. So, this one's a lot warmer colors than the last one, of course. But both are hilly regions and both are very beautiful. So, I'll show you both of them together, but let me show you the features of this painting first. So, this sky, you've got this nice pink sunset. Sunrise sky. You have little flecks of darker and lavender purple for the clouds, and there's also little bits of white too. Also clouds, but a little bit more distant, a little bit more misty. The gnarled lines, yeah. So then you have several mountains. You've got one back here. She's also added these light and dark lines right on the border to really accentuate the differences in the colors, yeah. And then down here is a little oasis. And of course it's pink and white because it's reflecting from the sky. And you can see a couple of shrubs and bushes just right around. And a little bit of their reflection in the water itself. Yes. You'd like to see them both side by side, of course. Do you like them? Yeah. Do you think that you want to get them as a set today? $20 each just because you're getting them together. Yeah, is that okay?